It's always strange to welcome someone who's not here yet, but they'll be here soon. So I want to welcome Mr. Clinton and Congressman Engels, who's also on his way. Former President Diaz, who I understand is on his way. Senator Klein, who's on his way. Assemblyman Dinowitz, a good friend of the college. Assemblyman Jonah.
He's here.
And our city councilman, M.D. Cohen. And all of you. On behalf of the students, faculty, staff, and alumni of the College of Mount St. Vincent, welcome to the college. We're proud of our students and faculty. We're proud of this college. It represents the best in this country and the best of the American dream. A recent federal study identified only 5 independent and public colleges and universities in the United States that have demonstrated both a high commitment to socioeconomic inclusivity and to extraordinary student success. The federal government identified Mount St. Vincent as one of only 5. And I've asked you to think about that. That is a great source of institutional identity and pride, and it should be a great source of national shame that there are only 5 of us who are here in that slice of the American. And so it has been. 30 years ago, in the Philippines, a Mount Alumna, Corazon Aquino, led a nonviolent people power revolution that overthrew decades of corrupt dictatorship. That revolution served as a model for and an inspiration for the national peaceful revolutions that freed subjugated nations within the Soviet Empire, including, I should point out, Albania. Cori was a tough cookie. She had the fortitude, the courage, and the compassion of a saint. In her first year as a democratically elected president, she faced 5 coup attempts. She led a great nation back to democracy and to the rule of law. Her legacy is part of the universal agenda: liberty, justice, the rule of law, and opportunity for all. The Mount is not a partisan institution, but Cori credited the college with the definition of and confidence in her most fundamental commitments. We are committed to three fundamental values. First, an understanding of our common humanity. That means our equality, that every human being here and across the globe has worth, is equal. And second, a commitment, an understanding of and commitment to human dignity. That every human being has the obligation to find the best in themselves and to ask the best from others. And third, a full appreciation of our obligations to each other. That we make our way in life together, that we have an obligation to serve the communities in which we live, and to serve one another. It's not here yet, and we have a number of good friends in the audience, but I'd particularly like to call out Congressman Engel, who is an extraordinary friend of this college, and who lives those commitments and values with uncommon sincerity and integrity. And I think there's always a lot at stake in national elections. In this one, the stakes seem especially high. In ways startling and sometimes alarming, our most fundamental values, our most fundamental commitments as a people, as a nation, seem not to be a common ground on which we are competing, but rather our fundamental commitments as a nation seem imperiled. As American citizens, we all have an obligation to be clear with ourselves and with each other about the choices we are making and their implications for our shared future. In that context, to all of our guests, but especially to Mr. Clinton, welcome to the College of Mount St. Vincent. Councilmember Andy Cohen, and I have to tell you, I'm a little nervous. This is very, very exciting. I really want to thank Dr. Flynn and the whole college community for hosting us here today and providing this great venue. I really have been very excited about the whole campaign. You know, in my little corner of the Bronx, I represent the Northwest Bronx. We have a significant Albanian community, and we've all really pulled together. We've been phone banking. I don't know how many of you have gotten annoying phone calls from that's us calling from our local, our club. I have a trunk full of literature. I've really been going out and making the case. So I'm really excited to be here. I think this is going to be a real privilege and an honor for us to have former President Clinton here to address us all. And I really look forward to a great event. And now my partner, Assemblyman Dinowitz, is going to say a few words too. Thank you very much.
That President Bill Clinton has come to Riverdale, has come to my district. I guess something's going on. You know, many of you probably don't remember too well when President Clinton was president, especially if you're a student at Mount St. Vincent's. But I gotta tell you, when my kids were growing up in the 90s, I was always thankful that we lived in a time of incredible prosperity and peace. And that peace and prosperity took place while President Clinton was president and because President Clinton was president. I was very honored to serve as a delegate to the convention when he ran in the 90s. And I was just as honored to serve as a Hillary delegate 8 years ago. And you know what? I should tell you that Randy Bartels and I are running for delegates on Tuesday. So if you live in LA, the congressional district, please vote for us. You know, having seen Hillary Clinton in action, though, these past several years, and I guess we first met her when she ran for the United States Senate in 2000. And her talent is unmatched. The job she did as our New York United States Senator was incredible. She was a first lady, we all know that, but her work as a senator was really where she shined the greatest, I think. You know, she was not the type of person who simply introduced legislation, yelled and screamed, and said, oh, look, I introduced a great bill. She's the type of senator who actually got things done. She got bills passed, and they weren't just renaming post offices. They were real bills that affect lives of people, and she worked coalition with other people to get things done, other members of the Senate, to improve the lives of people in our community and throughout the state. And then she served as Secretary of State. I don't know if anybody who who comes into this race with the type of talent and credentials that she has. And I can tell you, looking at all the candidates, and I'm not going to say anything bad about, well, at least one of them I won't say anything bad about. But she is heads and heels above every one of those candidates. And you know, when we deal with the issues that we have that are confronting us, and we know what all the issues are, whether it's our reproductive rights, whether it's college loans, whether it's the cost of college, Social Security, Medicare and Medicaid, on every one of those issues, she has the ability and she has ideas as to how to really get things done for the people of our state and for our country. And so I hope that every one of you will really give serious thought to all the issues come Tuesday. And remember, when we vote on Tuesday, we're not just voting for somebody because we think that person is exciting or, you know, it's different. We have to vote for somebody who is going to actually deliver for us, to get things done for our country, to make things better. You know, President Obama came into office in the worst possible conditions, having had to deal with the President Bush's Great Recession. And it's taken years to get out of that. Now we have the opportunity to expand this incredible health care plan for more people. We have the opportunity to make life better for everybody. That's what Hillary Clinton is going to do. So I hope that you all come out on Tuesday. And I know that you don't all vote here. You may vote in different places. But this is the first time in years that the New York presidential primary actually means something, which might explain why President Clinton is here for the second time this week. And that's great. But it really means something, it really counts, it really makes a difference. Vote and really think about who you vote for, but come out and vote no matter who you vote for. Now I'm gonna end it there and just say we have some incredible talent coming up on stage in a few minutes. They're gonna be doing some really great dancing. So thank you all for coming out, and it's great to see you.